Hello, I am Test Drive, and welcome to another video of BeamNG, where in this episode everything's going to lag like crazy, apparently. Anyways, we are playing BeamNG again because I actually played this game for the first time in a while last night, and the newest update adds some really cool stuff. And this map is not one of those things because this is actually a modified map or mod. Why did I say modified map? But anyways, we're going to explore this map a little bit and see what it has to offer. Actually, I want to change my vehicle real quick. I found out my new, like, favorite vehicle of this game, like, that's just on this game, is this. Because it goes literally anywhere, and it's amazing. So we're going to go ahead and use the Roamer. And it's also two-tone. It's also an Explorer, kind of. Which is similar to a Ranger, which is, you know, what I have in real life. So, in the latest update, the big update that came out in, I think, December, may have been before... No, it would have been after I played this game last, or recorded last. They added a whole bunch of stuff, such as some car variations, some different tweaks to cars. The transmissions act more like real transmissions now, which is nice. Like, automatic transmission definitely does do something more like an automatic transmission would. So, it's definitely upgraded. Of course, it does run a little bit better than it used to. You know, like, oh my god, the speed bumps, I just realized. I didn't know what those were at first. Now let's go over here. So, oh god. Oh god, oh, I shouldn't have turned that way. Oh, my steering's broken. I think. No, maybe not. The hell? Okay. Yeah, like, this thing could take an absolute beating too. I don't know why or how, but this stupid SUV can like go forever and ever, and it's amazing. That was an actual, like, highway there. I'm just gonna go off this way and explore this way. Okay, no, never mind. This thing seems like it flip over pretty easily. My mirror is folded in on that side. I just realized, oh, it was actual, like, lights. Oh, no. Shouldn't have hit my brakes there. Yeah, the lights were red. Ah! Is it actually change? I'm curious. Is it actually going to change? It looks like it will, because it's, like, actual, like, lights. But it so far has done absolutely nothing. Go! I don't care. That was like a ramp you can take into the lake there. I don't think I'd want to do that, necessarily. Oh my. It appears that the road is flooded. Oh god. So I can actually make it through this without killing myself, aka finding a branch that's too big, like that. Ah! Get off of the branch, you dingus! The bad part is that, actually, you know what I could do? We're gonna just do this and go over here real quick. And, I guess... Will it actually work? Oh, no. Oh, no. So that car's dead. Anyways, let's get a new car. And I found another vehicle I really like. Okay, anyways, I fixed it. So, yeah. So I really like the fact that they added extended cab trucks in this game. It makes me really happy, and apparently I'm... Oh! Pfft. Go! Get off of... Okay. It's still alive. We're just gonna keep it like this. But yeah, it makes me really happy that they added, like, extended cab trucks. Because I actually had a mod a while ago that had extended cab trucks, quad cab trucks, which you don't really have. Or, crew cab, I guess, because this would be considered quad cab, technically. Because it has rear doors. Like step side versions and dualies and all kinds of stuff, which they actually did add dualies as well, which I was looking at spawning in, but then I realized I was looking for this truck. But yeah, it's definitely fun. I like that they're adding weird stuff in. Like, who would actually care about having an extended cab pickup over, you know, a single cab pickup? I think I only have one car mod myself, which is a Toyota Land Cruiser, if I remember right. Like a 2000s Toyota Land Cruiser. Also, I wish I was using my wheel for this, but I kind of have nowhere to put it right now, and nowhere to put it easily. What the hell's going on here? Oh. Yeah, other things. You can, like, stall your cars finally and stuff. Is this all mud? Do I want to even attempt this? Because this truck's only rear-wheel drive. Let's see. I'm going to dip my front wheels in, see if they sink. If they do, I'm backing the fuck up. Well, so far it's not sinking. So that means drifting time! Not really. I didn't want to drift, damn it. Well, not for that long, at least. I'll see a license plate to a thing as well. Ah, balls. And of course, one thing I've always liked doing in this game is taking vehicles you should not take off-road, off-road. Okay, two-wheel drive trucks, and mostly that. I've done it before in my BeamNG videos. I'll do it again, damn it. Oh, Jesus, okay. Survived, maybe. Oh god, it's drifting. Surprised it didn't actually stall there. This thing's cool though. It's got like a limited slip differential. I think I was always using the four-wheel drive version of this too. It doesn't have the cool wheels on it though. That kind of makes me sad. Now where are we here? This map is gigantic. Holy shit. I've been driving for a while now and I want to go this way. I don't know what's this way, but we're going to turn. Oh god. Also, I've noticed that they did a Forza Motorsport thing, aka the tires like kind of deform as they have different like weight pressures on them. They may have had that for a while though. I don't really know, because like you could see them kind of bow in or out whenever you turn the front wheels. And I remember that was a big thing with like I think it was Forza 4 actually. It wasn't Forza 3. We're going off road apparently. As I said, taking vehicles that should not be taken off-road, aka a high-powered rear-wheel drive extended cab pickup. It'd be like an extended cab Ram SRT10, kind of. Saying there's not really many, like, equal real-life vehicles to this. Oh my god. Nothing is broken yet. We're good. Oh god. Make it up the hill. Where does this go? Nobody knows. Oh shit. It's like Pike's Peak. Speaking of Pike's Peak, I need to re-download that map. If you remember, I actually did a video of a Pike's Peak map on this game a while ago. Oh, that was boring. I don't want to drive down the mountain, so we're just going to go back this way. At full speed. Full speed ahead. I'm probably going to die. Ask and you shall receive, I guess. Oh my god. Oh my god, it survived! It's alive! Also, the cool thing is, I'm pretty sure I downloaded a mod, if it actually is still on here. So what we're going to do, real quick, is we're actually going to escape out of that, do this again, go up here, and like over here, kind of, and then do this again. This guy, gonna spawn new, well, that'll probably kill my frame rate, and then we're going to, is it under, I think it is under this. Oh, there it is. Giant chain. So, now that we have this, what we're going to do is something crazy. So, we're going to switch back to this guy first off. Take the parking brake off. Go over here. Going to park right about here. Back up. Back up. Okay, put the parking brake on. And then hit this. Go to couplers. Toggle, so that'll put its dong on the ball, and then switch back to this, have a look behind me, even though it's a bad idea because the camera's gonna be like, oh hey, you wanted to look behind? You know, let's just, you know, do this. I don't know why I hate this, oh, okay. I don't like this camera that much. I like the orbit one better, aka the one I was like, have been using this entire video so far. Okay, and then parking brake on that. Do this again. Toggle. And we have two trucks attached to each other. So actually, I need to take the parking brake off on this guy. I can only see this ending badly because, yeah, this is going to roll. Unless I put it in. No, because of stick shift. Yeah, this is going to end badly. So I'm going to have to do. I have to hold the brake on this, and then left brake, go to this, and then, ah! Oh, jeez. Oh, no! We're going this way, apparently. Okay, I'm towing, kind of. It's, oh god, the other truck is going faster. Now, how do I stop the other truck? That's my question. Oh, god. No, don't hit a tree! Ah, it's pulling me. Let's go, okay, let's go down here to the, ah! Bastard! It just spins around. Okay, we'll go backwards then, I guess. Oh, God. I did not know what to expect with this because I just downloaded the mod last night and I never actually used it yet. So the problem I'm finding is that, yeah, that's happening. Okay, get the fuck out of here, buddy. Oh no, now it's wrapped around the bottom of the other truck. Well, I guess that maybe that's better, I don't know. Oh, there it goes. Oh, the rear bumper's gonna fall off. Hold on. Ah, stop. Let's try something out real quick here. That's not what I wanted. What the hell? Okay. So, it's somehow still attached. What we're gonna do is we're gonna put on the parking brake on this truck. Because I'm sure this truck has enough balls to pull the other truck even... Oh, goddammit. Ah, I'm forgetting that the parking brake works differently. So I'll be able to pull the truck with the parking brake on. Kind of. Slowly. Gain some speed. Now I wonder, like... I noticed that, like, if you do this and you hit the couplers and you hit toggle... Oh, shit. Toggle. There we go. It shows that there's one in the front. So I wonder, I'm going to detach real quick. We're going to do a little, actually, no, I don't want to do that. I want to detach it from the other truck. Hold on. Let's fix this real quick. You just have to be kind of somewhat close with this. Couplers, toggle, that should zoobity zop right in there. Yep. And then do that. Oops. There we go. Do that. What am I? Okay. Oh, I'm the chain. I am the chain. Wait, is there something you can do with the chain? No. So, gonna go back to this, go back to couplers, detach, oops, detach. Do a nice little quick spin here in this guy. Because I'm pretty sure it'll be easy to pull from the front with the parking brake. Oh, look how detailed the engine is, holy shit. Pull from the front, no, that's not gonna work, is it? Why does it have a thing there if you can't attach it to it? It needs like we need like an actual towing truck or tow truck. I'm sure there's probably mods for that, although I don't know if there's any for the newest build of the game. And now the silly idea I have now is if we go to hit Control and W, maybe, there we go. I can go to the engine and put a stage 3 supercharger on it, which gives it like a metric fuck ton of horsepower. So, let's go ahead and attach this guy again. Get rid of that menu, take the parking brake off, and I'm pretty sure this truck will definitely have enough balls to pull it now. Needs four-wheel drive, though. That's a problem. Okay, maybe not. Oh, geez. It doesn't really want to pull it that well. And it also is making the temperature of this truck go up really high, really quickly. This is quite the fucking silly thing going on right here, right now. Okay, anyway, let's go this way. Oh, jeez. Oh, no! I popped my tire. That's not good. One of my drive wheels is no longer a drive wheel. Come on, we need that torque. It's not really... The torque isn't really happening. But I'm pulling it! I'm sure shit pulling it. I wonder if this map has any, like, you know, repair shops or anything, like, silly I can go to. Let's go... not that way. Guess we'll just continue down the highway here and see where it leads me. I like a tow bar mod. I need to do that. If any BeamNG modders are watching this, you should definitely do a tow hook. Or a tow, a flat towing, oh god, hitch. Because that would work out actually fairly well, I think. Not this floppy-ass dick chain you got here. Uh-oh, this truck is overheating. I think we're gonna have to detach. Emergency detach! Oh, that's not right. Ah! Oh god. No! Detach! Later, nerd! Oh god. Probably because of the supercharger, this thing's like overheating like crazy. Okay, we're just gonna leave that truck out here to like, you know, get impounded and shit. This truck is way too goddamn fast. Speaking of fast, I wonder how fast it will go in a straight line. Also, I like how, like, whenever you have automatic clutch on, it like makes the truck fucking rev to the red line. If you have any kind of throttle input whatsoever while shifting. Okay, remember we have a somewhat flat rear tire there. I don't know if that's more flat. Okay, I survived. I don't know if it's more flat or if it's like just completely just popped. Oh, geez. Because it said deflated, but I'd consider that a little bit more than deflated. Because I'm pretty sure it popped whenever I hit that curb. I need, like, a really long straight road. I don't know if I'll find one of those around here at all. I mean, there's... Oh, God. Ah! It wants to turn to the right really bad. Oh, geez. Oh, it stalled. And I can start it again. I don't know if it's stalled because of overheating or if it's stalled I guess it's probably stalled because of going backwards in a forward gear. It's a good reason for it to stall. Why is my steering messed up? Oh my god! Well, oh, it still drives! Oh my god. How in the hell does this thing still drive? Oh, doesn't really drive very well though. Is that cab lights actually turn on? They do. Right? Yeah, I can see them. So anyways, I think I'm going to go ahead and end this video here. So thank you all for watching this BeamNG video. If you have any like suggestions of shit to do in this game, because like it's really entertaining to do, but you have to like find your own shit to do, leave them down in the comments below, and I will check them out whenever this video goes up. So thank you all for watching, and I'm out of here. See ya.